Hello everyone. Today I'm going to start a basics of Rhino for all those who would love to learn this program. I'll start from with describing all of the comments and all of the very important things at your stage in Rhino. So let's start. I'm using Rhino to model objects for industrial designing because I'm also industrial designer. I'm making a molding modeling and all this important stuff to do market input products. Okay, so I will show you how I'm doing. Everything I'm actually doing is going to be very, very much industrial cooperative. So I hope it will help you to develop your products and your objects. Okay, so I'm also teacher of Rhino in two schools, so it might help me to communicate with you as well. Okay, so look at the left on your corner of your screen. This is the most important place. This is all comments are placed there. So basically this area here is area where you're creating and modifying curves. This area here, it's basically to create and modify your surfaces. And this area here, it's area to create and modify your solids. And all of these icons underneath, on the bottom of this old modificators, are modificators for all of them. So you can, for example, rotate, you can split, you can join, you can copy, you can pay, you can move or something, each of these. So, and the same is here. If you want to create line or you can create circles or something, you always also have a curve tools, because these features all are called curves. So this is also curve tools, which will help you to individual and modify each of them. So the same is here, you can find surfaces, and also you can modify surfaces by surfaces tools, which is actually very, very helpful. And also the same here, solid and solid tools. So there are a couple of features like a sphere, which actually is quite strange feature because it's surface curved around, which actually it's solid, which you will see later how we go on with this. Okay, so how to do anything in your Rhino stage? Here you are four views as usual in CAD designing tools, which is top, front, right and perspective window. If you click right mouse on the name of the window, you've got all helpful comments, helpful menu, which will, for example, give you a shading of your models, which you'll set your view and what you like, and many differences we will meet later. Perspective window is a window where everything when you can see everything clearly and nicely what you design. So I forgot about the top bell, top tools. These tools are mine tools, like in every CAD program. You can, for example, print, you can save, you can hide, you can block, you can kind of layers, which are not straight communicated with the modeling, just helps to model everything you're doing. So okay, how to, for example, use mouse in Rhino, which sometimes might be very difficult in different programs. If you want to zoom and zoom out, you just need to scroll your scroll mouse. But the good thing is that you are scrolling to your pointer and scrolling out and zooming out of the pointer. So this is quite important. and sometimes quite tricky, because you can get really messed up and at the beginning of your process, learning process. So be patient to learn learn it well, to not get angry, really bad with designing. Okay. If you want to keep focus at the one creation plane, like a top view, you can twice click on a name on a, with right button, mouse button, and then your window will extend to all view, which is quite quite cool. Here you, on the right side, you've got layers, which we'll actually meet later, just forget about right now, it's not that important. So, if you want to, for example, rotate, turn your perspective view, you just press right button and just move it. And the same, if you do the same in the top view or front view, just move the view, which is quite quite helpful sometimes. Here you've got an axis gumball, and you can orient yourselves in many comments you find on the left side. Basically, this is a couple of very important things about the program. Here, on the bottom of your window, you've got something which is very important and will directly responsible for your precision, which is actually snapping. Here you've got end, near, point, and other. If you select them, your the next kind of creation idea will start from certain point, which for example is end, near. So if I'll create a curve here, and I want to start my next curve from the middle of the point, I've got a middle selected. So if I will, if I'll just make a, just be close to the curve, you see the small applet goes out and tell me that I'm exactly in the middle. And now look, if the near is selected, if I'm on the curve, the near is appearing, yeah? And I'm on the end is appearing. This is very important, and it really, really does the job with the precision of your models, and then after the printing, 3D printing, and exporting STL to other engineers or to other people who are responsible for projects. So this is basically it about that. And also here you've got something which is sometimes helpful. Which is snapping, ortho, and planar in OSnap. OSnap is object snap, which is actually disabling and enabling this bar. Planar means that if I will start my creation, for example, curve creation in certain point, the next point will be created at the same plane. So this is quite helpful tool. Ortho means that I'm going to be making anything in orthogonic directions. So look, if I want to create a curve from here, every time I point my pointer on the left or right or top, bottom, it's going to be just 90 degrees creation. You don't have to have it turned on. You can use shift. If I will press shift, it does the same job. So it's very much more helpful just using shift than having ortho on all the time. I don't use snapping because it's only disturbing in design process. So planar is very important, and you can have it turned on all the time. Okay, so let's start to create anything in our stage. So I want to create curve, for example, from 0 point or from any point at the beginning. So I'm going to pick up the polyline comment, and look what happened. Here you've got a help like a comment which will tell you what to do. So now look, my pointer changed for cross. So now I can choose the destination of my point. So I choose here, for example. And look here, the next point of polyline. The software automatically telling you what to do, which is very helpful if you don't know. When you get advanced, you won't be using this that much, but sometimes you get confused and you might really need it. So anyway, let's do next point here. Okay, and what next? Next point of polyline. Enter, press enter when done. This is very helpful because now if I will press just enter on the keyboard, or in Rhino, it's also when you open a comment, the right button of mouse does the enter job. So I'm just pressing right mouse button, and the process is ended. I can continue. Look, I can continue this creation as much as I want, and if I will finish at the point, the comment will automatically stop, which is good. So basically, this is how to use, how to start, how to say hello to the software, and how to do anything. In further tutorials, I'm going to describe almost each one of these tutorials. So follow me, please, and you'll learn this quite quick. And I can tell you that this program is not difficult at all. So see you next time.